hope you had a restful 3-day weekend, fourth grade. Good to see you. Okay, we're starting a new chapter, chapter 9, and it's all about angles. So let's learn how to name rays and angles. Look at this example. I see that I have a point here. Then from the point, I have a line drawn with an arrow at one end. This is called either ray AB or is it called ray BA? Only one of these choices is right. This is called ray AB because whenever we name a ray, we always name the end point first. A first here in this case is the end point, and B is the ray part where it continues on, where the arrow goes on and on and on and on and on. Okay, so it's called ray AB because it starts with the end point A. Now ray BA actually will look like this, where B is at the end point and A is where the arrow is, and we will say this and read this as ray BA. Now look at this figure. It's a little different than this figure, isn't it? How do you see it being different? What's different? Well, I see in this figure, CD, that there's two arrows on either end. Here we had an end point and an arrow, right? Here we have an arrow and an arrow, okay? Now this is not a ray because there are two, both sides have an arrow at the end. So this is actually called a line. Remember number lines? Number lines have arrows at the end, don't they? Okay. So this is can be called line C, D, or D, C. Here, order doesn't matter because there's no end point to start with. We can also denote this with this line here. Okay, showing CD with this line above. You know how there's a line with arrows at both ends? And or you can see it as DC, where there's again a line above with arrows at both ends. Now look at this, EF. How is EF different from CD and AB? Well, EF has only endpoints. I don't see any arrows. So this is actually called a line segment because it starts and ends somewhere. Now because there's two endpoints, order of these letters don't matter. Because each point can be an endpoint, right? So you can start here and then go there, or you can start here and go there. So it can be line segment EF or FE, or you can denote it as EF with this line above it, or FE with this line above it. And just a line without the arrows says that it's a line segment. So this is a ray, this is a line, and behind my little picture there is a line segment. Okay? In my video, I mean. All right. Here's another example. Notice I have two rays. I have ray PA, I also have a ray PB. When two rays meet at the same endpoint, that endpoint is called a vertex and it creates an angle. So ray PA and ray PB are rays meeting at point P, but P is called the vertex. And this creates an angle, as you can see. And the angle that's created is right here. And they drew this little curve to show you, oh, we're measuring the angle right there. Now you can call this angle two ways. You can call it angle APB, or you can call it angle BPA. You can use three letters to denote it as an angle, where the vertex P is always in the middle because that's where these two rays meet. Now, sometimes your math textbook will label the angle itself. It'll give it a lowercase letter like x or y or z or r, but it'll be lowercase. Notice that the points of the ray or the points of the angle are capitalized. But when it labels an angle here like this, like x, it is lowercase. So you can also denote this angle as angle x. Okay? We don't call it angle P because sometimes there might be another ray that'll come out of there, and then if you call it angle P, you don't know which angle it's talking about. Okay, so with the vertex, we'll always use three letters, okay, where the vertex is in the middle, or if there's another lowercase letter that's named as that angle, then you can call it that lowercase letter, angle X here in this case. All right, pause the video, try numbers 1 through 4 on your own. See you soon. Hi. All right, so let's name the angles. So we have to name the angle at P. So P is here. So we have to name this angle here. So to name this angle, I see it's this side and that side that make that angle. Like so. So I know P then would be my vertex. So my vertex has to be in the middle. So there's two ways I can label this angle. This angle SPQ or angle QPS. Notice here, I always put this angle sign here. This angle sign is different than the less than sign. Notice this line here, it looks like it's on the floor, right? Okay. So an angle sign looks different than a less than sign. It almost looks similar, but it's a little bit different. Okay? And whenever we label an angle, we want to draw that angle symbol. Okay, so it's angle SPQ or angle QPS. And we want to make sure if the letters are capitalized, we have to keep it capitalized. Alright. Now at angle Q, angle at Q, this is not angle Q, right? This angle at Q is here, right? So it's PQR or RQP. Oh, I didn't write PQR, it was PQS by mistake. It should be PQR over here, okay? All right. Angle at R over here. So let's see, it would be QRS or SRQ. And angle at S, here is S. So then it'll be PSR or RSP. Ooh, Cookie Monster's happy you're getting it. All right, can you pause the video and do numbers 5, 6, and 7? See you soon. Hi again. All right, so we're gonna name these angles. And so notice here, ray BA and ray BC meet at B. So B is my vertex. Here, ray YX and ray YZ meet at Y. So Y is my vertex. Here, ray FG and ray FE meet at F. So F is my vertex. So here, I see that my vertex will always go in the middle, right? When I name my angle. So my angle can be ABC or it can be angle CBA. In this case here, my angle can be XYZ or Y or ZYX. And here, my angle can be labeled GFE or EFG. Sloth is amazed at your speed and your comprehension. Thank you for always trying your best. Okay, all right, our last set. Okay, please do guided practice numbers 8, 9, 10, and 11. Okay, see you soon. All right, let's check number 8. So it says we're gonna name the angle another way. So angle X is here, right? This is my angle X, okay? So it looks like it's here and here, right? So then that means A is my vertex, okay? So vertex A will always be in the middle when I name my letter. So it'll be BAD or DAB, okay? Let's look at 9, it's Z, angle Z. Here's my letter Z, right? It's lowercase. So it's here and here that make up the legs of that angle, okay? And so that looks like it's at vertex D, right? So you can label that angle as B, D, C, or C, D, B. Remember, we cannot do C, Z, B, okay? Because Z is not a point, okay? Z is just a name of that angle, all right, that was given. The point here is D, another point here is C, another point here is B, okay? All right, and then let's look at angle Y, which is here, all right? So it would be D, B, C, or C, B, D. And then angle R, it's right here, so that would be A, D, B, or B, D, A. Yeah, you're doing a stellar job. Okay. All right. Well, that's all for today, and I will see you next time. Bye.